जो 25% काम था उसकी जिम्मेदारी भी भारत सरकार उठाएगी। ये व्यवस्था आने वाले 2 सप्ताह में लागू की जाएगी। जून सोमवार से देश के हर राज्य में 18 वर्ष से ऊपर की उम्र के सभी नागरिकों के लिए भारत सरकार राज्यों को मुफ्त वैक्सीन मुहैया कराएगी।
हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर वाचिंग न्यूज एपिसेंटर विद मी मारिया शकील। इंडिया मे बी कॉल्ड द फार्मेसी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, बट फॉर वीक्स इंडिया हैज फेल्ड to effectively execute its vaccination drive, leaving many without this critical defense. The decentralized vaccine policy has inoculated less than 19 crore with the first dose and less than 5 crore with both doses, with the states and the center continuously sparring with each other over the vaccine supply. First, the states asked for a liberalized policy, and then they accused the center of imposing many roadblocks with vaccine quotas. After global tenders failed to boost the vaccine supply, the states again turned to the center for procurement as the second wave comes under control and the threat of the third wave looms large. The Supreme Court also came out to criticize the new vaccine policy, calling it arbitrary and irrational, which left the states with little bargaining power. Now, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced that the vaccination drive will now be centralized. 75% procurement will be done by the center, which will give the vaccines for free to the states, ensuring free vaccines for all from June 21st. The constant shifting of the vaccination policy has not helped anyone. But does this move show that the states were unprepared for managing the vaccine drive? Does it also show that the logistical challenges for the transport and storage of vaccines is too daunting a task for a state to handle on its own? Has the debate between what should be done finally settled with this procurement, which will now be a centralized model? And is this the best way to perhaps, I would say, only the only way to reboot the vaccination drive? Joining me first on the show is Rajesh Tope. He is the health minister of Maharashtra. Mr. Tope, I appreciate your time. Prime Minister has announced that now the central government will be procuring vaccines and giving it to the states. It is something that all of you have been demanding for way too long. Do you think this decision has been taken at the right time?
They should facilitate the availability of the vaccine. That was our demand. And I really appreciate that Government of India has taken a right decision and they have accepted our demand. So I thank central government for this decision. And I thank Honorable Prime Minister, I thank Honorable Health Minister, Mr. Dr. Harshavardhan, for this decision.
And Mr. Tope, you know, we have seen a lot of politics as well. In the last few days, several state chief ministers writing to the center that there has to be a universal vaccination program. Do you think we will now be seeing a coordinated effort between the center and the states? And is this also a realization among the states that health is, yes, a state subject, but it is something that you have failed as well in your respective states on?
No, I think this vaccination has always been a mandate for Government of India and the federal government, the state, the central government. And so they have taken right decision that they are doing from their own, they are procuring for the entire nation and they are providing vaccines to the entire nation. So as like the vaccination program, which is being implemented for the age group plus 45, so safe will be done for 18 to 44, and I think we can vaccinate quickly, and there will be a proper coordination, and I think there will be a single command from the central government and that we will be adhering very much.
Yes, and before this entire eligibility criteria was rejigged of including 18 to 44, we did see several chief ministers, including the chief minister of Maharashtra, writing to the center of lowering this eligibility criteria, and they were also demanding that the states be made stakeholders. You floated global tenders and then hit a roadblock. So is there also an acknowledgement that the demands of the states that they be made stakeholders was also not correct?
No, basically the demand we never made that the state government should be given the authority to purchase and all. It was never a demand from our side, but once it was decided by from the central government, we accepted it and we went for the global tender as the mandate was fixed to the state. So we immediately took action and we went for the global tender. There was a response, but still it was not very appropriate. And so continuously, I personally was demanding the central government that they should come up with a national import for vaccine or national vaccine import policy.
Okay. You know, now that the center has taken charge in many ways, what is it that the states want? Do you want some say in determining those who should be made eligible within the state for vaccination, as has been a demand of several chief ministers?
Absolutely. I think there are a lot of demands from lot many sectors, like the press. They are demanding that as they are on roads continuously, so they should be given they should be considered as a frontline workers. Even the pharmaceuticals shops, they are continuously open even in the COVID first phase, first and second wave. They are not closed any time, and so they are also continuously demanding that they should be treated as frontliners. Not even then, all the veterinary doctors, even the lot many sectors, even the airport cargo handlers and even the passenger handlers of the airport, they are also continuously saying that we are continuously on front line, so we should be treated as a frontliners. So my personal wish is that yes, there should be a proper study that which of the sectors are really in the front line, and so they should be considered as a front line.
Before I let you go, the charge is that there are 9 states, including Maharashtra, which have underutilized vaccines which were given to them from January to March. Maharashtra, for example, received 14.3 million doses from the center till 31st of March, but used only 6.2 million doses. What will be your defense?
There is no vaccines at present with the government or with the state. We had whatever the state central government has sent to us or has supplied us, we had utilized to the fullest. And we are number one state who has administered highest number of vaccines, and even the utilization is to the mark. Means I don't think there is any vaccine left with the state government, with the state unutilized.
All right, Rajesh Tope, I appreciate your time. Thank you so much for joining us on News Epicenter. Let me bring in my guests now. Zafar Islam, Member of Parliament of the BJP. Professor Anupam Sibal is the Group Medical Director and Senior Pediatrician at Apollo Hospitals. Professor Dilip Mavlankar is Director IIPHG, and Charan Singh Sapra representing the Congress. Dr. Sibal, despite vaccination milestones, we have partially vaccinated just 10% of our population and have fully vaccinated less than 3%. And looking at these numbers, would you say that the only option that was there was centralized procurement and then distribution to the states to ensure that they vaccinate, and the decision and the announcement have happened today?
Thank you, Maria, for the invitation. So, you know, let's get the fundamentals very clear here. What are we aiming to do? We have a population of 1.35 billion people. We want to vaccinate 100 crore people as soon as we can. So the policy will continue to evolve. There will be roadblocks. There will be ways to ensure that, you know, we bypass the roadmap. So whatever it takes needs to be done to make sure that we get to 5 million vaccines a day and then move on to 10 million a day. Now, you know, this comparison with the US is very important because after India, it's Brazil. Brazil's at 7 crores. We are at 23 crores. United States is at 30 crores. So let's look at when the US started. They started on 14th of December. They started 32 days before us. And let's look 32 days ago, where were they? They were at 25 crores. We are at 23 crores. So, you know, one way of looking at it is, yeah, our numbers are not in keeping with our population size, fine. But 23 crores is huge. The US, with every possible resource, with a pipeline that was catering to the US, with millions of doses of Astra sitting there, were at 25 crores. We are at 23 crores. And they hit to 4.63 million doses in one day. That's the highest. We've also done 4.3. So I think the focus, the narrative, the discourse has to be about let's do 5 million a day. Let's do 10 million a day. Let's do whatever it takes to get to that figure. Let's smoothen the process, the logistics, the procurement, getting more vaccine companies to come into India. And obviously,
this is also a fact. Yes, while we look at those numbers and make a comparison with US, the fact is that India is unique in many ways. And that is the reason why the challenge is very different. Would you also say that given the nature and the number, the overall vaccination drive was slowed down, particularly 1st of May onwards. And hence, that announcement that had come that all the eligibility criteria being lowered from 18 to 44 age group should have happened only and only when we had enough vaccines. It was more reactionary than an action driven.
So the thing is that, you know, let us also not discount the fact that there is a lot of misinformation and incomplete information that has also resulted in vaccine hesitancy. And even in the United States, from 25 crores to 30 crores, they've taken 30 days. 32 days to be precise. Okay. So there will be times where people will say, no, I'm not going to get vaccinated because of clots and so on and so forth. So from time to time, we'll have that. So this is a huge, huge task. I mean, a task of this nature has not been undertaken ever in the history of humanity. So I think we need to look at it from the perspective of, listen, what is it that we can do to fast track? And let's okay. focus on that. Let's talk about removing. Let's look at
solutions now that the entire procurement has been centralized. Charan Singh Sapra, I think Rahul Gandhi and other chief ministers, as we are seeing a long list of chief ministers now, all of them are thanking the prime minister, saying, yes, we wanted this, you have done so. So is this also a realization in several states that yes, health may be a state subject, but when it comes to procurement, what the center was doing initially was the right thing to do, procuring it and giving it to the states till the time states wanted to be made a stakeholder, and then the entire thing got messed up.
See, Maria, if you see the whole vaccination policy of Narendra Modi government, it shows that, you know, there was a policy paralysis as far as vaccination is concerned. And it was time and again pointed out by Srimati Sonia Gandhi, Shri Rahul Gandhi and all the opposition leaders also. It was also pointed out by various high courts, whether it was Mumbai High Court or Madras High Court or Allahabad, Kanpur High Court. Delhi High Court went to the extent of, you know, saying that a case of manslaughter should be registered. So there has been, you know, everybody has been pointing out towards the deficiencies in this vaccination policy. And if today Narendra Modi has corrected that vaccination policy, it is for the good of the country. And it is the same thing which Congress was demanding. So he has agreed to the demand of Congress party. Hence, we welcome it, number one. Number two, why we have lost so much time in doing this correction? It is 1.5 months we have lost in this. And secondly, 6.6 crores vaccines have been exported. So if you connect this 6.6 crores vaccines which were exported,
you will also and 1.5 month loss, Chief Minister then, of then Punjab, then you, to do also, some course
then you also see that what was the loss which the people of India have
unfolded there. The government of Punjab also has much to explain. The data that has emerged out in the public domain now, see, of yes. the states, listen to me, sir. Of the states, nine states in all, yeah. which includes Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, Punjab, Delhi, Maharashtra, all of them together accounting for maximum vaccine underutilization. So there are vaccines which have been underutilized as well. While your demand may be right, but there is mismanagement at the state level.
No, see, Maria, I would like to make it clear. You just showed the Maharashtra health minister now, Mr. Tope. He has clarified it was not a mismanagement. Likewise, the chief minister and the health minister of Rajasthan has clarified. The health minister of Chhattisgarh has also clarified. This is a false perception being made by the Bharatiya Janata Party. If you go into the actual figures of the state, you won't find a mismanagement of vaccination drive in these states.
Okay.
What about the mismanagement we have seen when we have seen hundreds of bodies flowing in Ganga River, when we have seen
the centers vaccination policy or absence of it by multiple courts including the Supreme Court. In fact, the Supreme Court only on Wednesday said that prima facie it is arbitrary and irrational, and it had said, communicated to the central government, that they should submit within 2 weeks an affidavit which will talk about all relevant documents and file notings that will reflect if you had a strategy at all. Immunizing a country as big as ours is a challenge, but would you also accept that now that the Prime Minister has said that there will be a centralized procurement and the center has taken charge, when the center announced that the doses will be split in a ratio of 50:25:25 between center, states and private hospitals, it was an ill-conceived idea.
Maria, let me respond to that. First of all, it was always centralized procurement till many of these opposition states demanded that they are better equipped to source vaccine from different countries and they will be able to vaccinate their people faster than the supply which is they are getting from the central government. But when that flexibility which they demanded even on 20th of May, Mr. Rahul Gandhi also tweeted and asked for to be given more flexibility to states in terms of giving them flexibility to procure on their own. When that flex was given to them, you know what had happened. They failed miserably and then they had to come back to the center and requesting that, why don't you procure on behalf of all the state? And that is what the Honorable Prime Minister has made the announcement today, that yes, we will procure. You wanted that to need to be decentralized. We did it for because it's a cooperative federalism and we have to ensure that that the aspiration of all the states also
was it been addressed. Cooperative federalism, Zafar Islam, or sending a message to the states that you tried to do something, you failed, and now I am trying to handhold you.
See, no, when the operation was absolutely smooth. There was no hiccups.
Yes.
The procurement 100% was done by the central government and was being supplied to the states. At that juncture, who made this observation? Who asked for that flex? It is the state, opposition state, because they felt that they can source it better and faster than the central government. And that's what some of the chief minister have also made the announcement. Like, for instance, the Delhi chief minister said, I can vaccinate within 3 months. They have been given flexibility to vaccinate, but they failed. But I'm not talking about the failure part, because they wanted that flex. That flex was given to them. But today, the Honorable Prime Minister made that announcement that, yes, everybody will be given. That will be sourced from the central government and will be provided to the states. But still, you see, the Maharashtra state, Maharashtra health minister, what did he say on your channel? And you just see what the health minister of Chhattisgarh was saying. There is a clear, clearly they are sitting on two different platforms and speaking two different languages. They are not echoing each other. That suggests that there is a they just want to do politics on issues which need not be.
I'm coming back to the politicians in just 2 minutes.
The more they will politicize, the more
comments from Professor Mavlankar and Anupam Sibal. Professor Mavlankar, would you say that this announcement is the much needed policy course correction on vaccination and all the issues that we have seen in the last few weeks, be it global procurement, and rightly so, the vaccine manufacturers, they're saying that they would be dealing only with the government of India because it relates to indemnity waiver, and hence why would they engage with any respective states, because they cannot make changes in the law. So this move will ensure that the entire process gets streamlined, similar to the robust national immunization program that we have, which will come into aid of this implementation of this policy now.
Yeah, I think this policy is very welcome, and it is very much, it was needed. Now the next step we have to think is how to get more and more vaccines. And as I had earlier also said, it is an emergency authorization. We must have emergency speed at giving vaccines and ensure that zero wastage happens, because there is also policy wastage in the past. That also we should avoid, that if the vial is opened and people are not available, we should call them and finish the vial or vaccinate till the vial is finished. So even 12 hours opening of the vaccine centers and even jumbo vaccine centers, wherever vaccine is available, should be thought so that we can vaccinate as soon as possible, as much as vaccine available, with most secure and safety precautions being undertaken.
Professor Sibal, what do you think? As far as the numbers are concerned, these are a huge population that we are looking at. 594 million people in this age group of 18 to 44 group, according to the census 2011. That's a huge number, certainly. The government is hoping by the end of the year, they will have 2 billion doses to vaccinate the entire population. Now this central procurement has happened. Will we be seeing similar vaccine shortage stories that continue to come? And what will be the new front that you anticipate states opening up?
Well, I think, we really need to be very clear. We need to vaccinate. Our entire energy needs to, other than procurement, to be on administration. We have 500 medical colleges. We have fourth year medical students. We have final year medical students. We have interns. There is no shortage of vaccinators. We should be able to vaccinate if we focus a lot of energy there onto 10,000 per medical college. I mean, let's think out of the box. We are using malls, we are using schools, we are using office spaces, we are using RWAs, we are using different stadia. So let's use the medical colleges as well, and let's really do it like nobody has ever thought of doing it, and let's hit that magical figure of 10 million a day. It's possible. We can do a crore a day. And if the vaccine supply is going to be as much as 130 million by July, then we should be hitting that number in August and be able to vaccinate 30 crore people in a month.
Okay. Let me give the final words to the two politicians on the show. And Charan Singh Sapra, I'll begin with you. Will we be now seeing an end to politics and all the states, various political parties, the chief ministers, the health ministers, now doing what is expected of them to vaccinate the population?
See, Maria, let me tell you that this government has promised 216 crore vaccines till December 31st of this year. Now, let me give you a calculation. They have inoculated around 23 crore people till today. If you deduct that, nearly 195 crore doses are to be given to the people. This will exactly require 90 lakh or 1 crore doses per day. What is the speed today? 13 lakh to 14 lakh doses per day. That is the speed today. Last month, we had around 28.6 lakh people getting vaccinated per day. With this speed, this government will take, 1.5 years to inoculate everybody. Till then, there is a fear that the third wave will come.
So what is the
and
solution?
The third wave should not be
devastating. Propose a solution.
That is the biggest fear.
You wanted procurement to be done by the center. Center has agreed. Now, what is the solution for this? How do you speed up?
No, I am trying to point out who's responsible for the flaws. Narendra Modi should apologize to the nation that why he did not ramp up the domestic production in time, why he did not bring overseas vaccines in time, why he brought in the differential pricing policy which created confusion, why he wasted 6 months for this vaccination.
Can I just respond,
policy
please?
To be corrected.
Could the government have acted earlier?
Maria, I think they should not see India in isolation. They should see the world, the whole world. is looking for vaccine, and there are many countries, they cannot even procure vaccine in 2023 or 2024. We are fortunate that we have a prime minister who could source it, who could ramp up production, who could set up the system here to produce that gigantic number of vaccine in the country itself. And I must tell you, the production will get ramped up, including the what we are importing from different countries. But in August, we will have 35 crore. In September, we will have 46 crore. In October, we will have 50 crore. In November, we will have around 55 crore. And in December, 60 crore. So with this kind of production figures. Schedule we already have, we, Maria, ask yes. him to just be civilized.
Yes, yes, yes. 20 seconds of my producer has told me to end the discussion.
I am civilized.
All I'm saying that all I'm trying to tell you that the country will be vaccinated.
Okay.
The people of this great country will get vaccinated, and those who are trying to use this as an opportunity to politicize it and do politics here, it is a stunt for them, and the entire country will be vaccinated soon. That is what the government of India is hoping with this
centralized procurement announcement that has happened today. I would like to thank the guests. That's all from me. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll be seeing you tomorrow.